This is the tutorial for Chapter 9, Section 4, titled Factoring to Solve Equations. And this is day number 1. We'll be spending 2 days on this topic. And so let's take a look at our first problem here. We're solving by factoring. So the key is to first factor the equation. We always need it set equal to 0. And we can go ahead and factor. Again, as we factor, we're looking for numbers that multiply to make 15. In this case, they subtract because of this negative sign right here. They subtract to make a positive 2. So again, the outer terms minus the inner terms are going to end up subtracting to make a positive 2, and that's what we're looking for. So I'm going to go ahead and use 5 and 3. Those will subtract to make 2. To make it a positive 2, I need to make 5 positive, 3 negative. So now what we're going to do is we're going to use something called the zero product property. And it comes from a couple things. First of all, we've got zero. Zero means, well, we've got it equal to zero. Product means multiply. So this means to times. And so we're going to multiply two numbers to equal zero. Well, the property is that if we multiply a number to equal zero, that means it must mean one number is zero. So what we're going to do is we are going to set one of these, we're going to set n plus 5 equal to zero to find out what makes this zero. So you see how n plus 5, we're going to set equal to 0 to find out what the value of n is to make that 0. So you see you have to do an opposite operation to get it to the other side, and your answer is negative 5. And it makes sense because, you see, if I was to plug in negative 5 in for n, say negative 5 plus 5, and then I plug in a negative 5 in for the other end, negative 5 minus 3, watch what happens. I get 0 times by negative 8, which just makes 0. So that's true. So I found one of the values of n. Well, the other value is to do the same thing. N minus 3 equals 0, so you have to add the 3 to both sides. So notice you always have to do that opposite operation to get the constant to the other side. And it works. Let's just check. See, if you put 3 in place of these n's, you get 3 plus 5. And I'm going to multiply that by 3 minus 3. Well, 3 minus 3 makes 0. 0 times doesn't matter what number this is. In this case, it's 8, positive 8 this time. And that still makes 0 equals 0. So we get that identity. So whenever you've got that, you know you have a true answer. So the answers here are negative 5 and positive 3. That is our solution set. So notice how whenever once you solve, whatever you have as your constant, your constant is going to go on the other side of the equal sign. So that's why it's going to switch signs. And so let's take a look at this next one. So when I factor, I always look at this last digit sign. It tells me what to do. It means the outer and inner terms this time add together to equal 10x. So I know 3 and 1 are the only numbers that multiply to make 3. I know I have a plus and a plus sign because they multiply to make a positive and add to make a positive. I just need to figure out how could I get positive 10. Well, let's try multiplying the 3 by 2. So 2x here and a 4x here. Say 2x and 4x make 8x squared, and you see the outside terms and inside terms, they'll add to equal 10x. So it works. And so now we've got the factor form, let's solve. So when we've got the coefficient in front of x, we don't just have the opposite of the constant as the answer. So what we have to do is two steps. So you see how you have to bring the 3 over, so you're subtracting 3, and we end up with 4x equals negative 3, and then you divide by 4. And so we get this as our answer, negative 3/4. So that's one of the solutions. If you put negative 3/4 here, the 4s would cancel, you'd have negative 3. Negative 3 plus 3 makes 0. And it doesn't matter what this number is, 0 times a number is going to end up equaling 0. So negative 3/4 is one of the answers. The other answer is 2x plus 1 equals 0. So you have to solve by moving the 1 to the other side. So you subtract that, and then you divide by the coefficients. So you have a negative 1/2. So negative 1/2 is the other solution. So our answers are negative 1/2 and negative 3/4. And that's our solution set. So notice a quick way to do this is you always move the term, the constant, over. So that always switches signs. So whatever the sign is was here, it's going to be the opposite on the other side. And then you divide by the coefficient. So it's basically just kind of turning this counterclockwise. 3 on top, 4 on the bottom, and switches sign as well. Well, in this one, in order to factor, you've got to get the equation, the quadratic, set equal to 0. So we've got w squared plus w equals, minus 12 equals 0. So minus 12 equals 0. So when I go ahead and factor this, it's going to factor to a w plus 4 and a w minus 3. Those numbers are going to outside terms and inside terms will subtract to make a positive w. And so that's what we end up getting here. So we have a set equal to 0, so we set w minus 3, I'll start with that one since I wrote it down first. I move it to the other side, that's going to give me one of my solutions for w. W equals 3, it's one of the answers. Well, w plus 4 equals 0, you got to subtract the 4 from all sides, and that gives us our other solution, negative 4. So negative 4 and positive 3, the two solutions. That'll make that case true, where they'll end up equaling 0 when we have it on one side, or it'll equal 12 if we just have w squared plus w. See how it works? It's 3 squared plus 3 makes 12. Negative 4 squared makes 16, minus 4 makes 12 as well. Well, let's try some other problems. On these problems, more factoring, just got to move the 12 back to the other side. And I've got 3j squared minus 20j, and then plus 12 equals 0. So when I factor this, a little more challenging problem because we got the coefficient, just like we had in the second problem. And 3j and j are the only numbers that make 3j squared. To make a positive 12 when I multiply but add to make a negative, I know both signs are negative. So in order to get 20, and I know that you have to add to make 20, I think I'll go ahead and multiply the 3 by a 6, and then the 2 by just the 1j, and that's going to give me 2j and 18j add to make negative 20j. So I know I've got the factoring done right, so I can go ahead and solve. So again, you're moving the 2, the constant, to the other side. That's why it switches sign. And then I divide by the coefficient. So there it is, j equals 2/3. For the other one, it's a little faster. You just have the one step of just moving the 6 to the other side, and you get your answer, j equals 6. So we've got our two answers, 2/3, comma, positive 6. Well, looking at our next problem, I've got to move the 7 back to the other side, and so I've got 12y squared plus 40y minus 7 equals 0. So again, the factoring technique I'm using is 7 and 1 multiply to make 7. I have opposite signs this time, so I know they subtract. Outer and inner terms, outer minus inner equal 40y. So I think I'm going to multiply the 7 by a 6. And that's going to give me 42, a little bit bigger. And then I've got 2y over here, and that makes 2y, so 42 minus 2 does make 40. So to make it a positive 40, I need to make the 7 positive, the 1 negative, and that will end up working out. And so from here, I just set the two factors equal to 0. So 6y minus 1 equals 0, and I got the 2y plus 7 equals 0. So I can solve them both together. So I move the 1 over, opposite operations, moves the 1, then I divide by 6, and notice how I get y equals 1/6. So whatever you have as your sign in here is going to switch signs because you got to move it to the other side. Same thing here, I got to subtract the 7. So that's why I'm left with 2y equals negative 7. Then you divide by the 2, and you get your answer. Negative 7/2 is the other value of y. So we have 1/6 and negative 7/2. So looking at the next problem here, I've got to move the 8 over, so I'm subtracting it. So 27r squared this time. So r squared plus 69r minus 8 equals 0. So when I'm factoring this, I'm thinking of outer and inner subtracting to equal 69. So I want the number that probably the outside terms I'll try, I'm going to break this 27 down to 9r and 3r. And you see, if I keep this as positive, or just 8, see that makes 72 here, and then I've got 3 right here, and those will subtract to make 69. To make a positive 69, I'll make the 72 positive. So plus sign with the 8, minus sign with the 1. That'll make it a negative 3r. So I know I've got the factoring done right, so I set up my two equations, and I use that zero product property. So I've got to add the 1, so that's why it's always opposite sign of whatever's inside the parentheses. So 9r equals 1, divide by 9, and you get your answer, 1/9. And then over here, subtract the 8, that's why it switches signs. 3r equals negative 8, divide by the 3, and you've got your answer, negative 8/3. And so those are the two solutions. And we'll see. So those are the types of problems you're going to see on tonight's assignment. Good luck.